Okay, I guess we are live. I'll just check. Just a second.
Yeah, it shows live.
Okay, so so we are live. Hello guys. Good afternoon. To all the people who are in India, right? And so today we have Parth joining us right from Perth, Australia. He's currently pursuing his master's in commerce, specialization in IT. Right. So Parth, why don't you, you know, introduce yourself and talk more about yourself, right? And just to add on, Parth also runs his YouTube channel, LTE Vlogs, right?
Firstly, thanks for having me here. It's like a great opportunity to gel with the audience and, you know, get to know people who are aspiring to do the same. So it's a good platform, firstly. I've done my bachelor's in BBA, which further specialized in banking and insurance. So initially in 12th, I had taken science, but, you know, I felt that I don't like it anymore. So that's why I switched my stream. And then I liked business, I liked commerce and everything. And then I decided to go for a master's in this particular setup because firstly, it gives me an exposure to commerce. And then it also gives me an exposure to IT as well. So I thought it was a perfect mix for me. And that's why I decided that.
Okay. Right. Awesome. And why did you choose Australia? Why not Canada or UK or the US? Why Australia?
Yeah, I get this question pretty often nowadays. But the thing is, actually, you know, this Australia thing was not planned at all. What happened is, you know, in 2017, I went to my aunt who lives in Sydney just for a random vacation. But then, you know, when I got to know the city, its education facilities, I actually went to a couple of campuses as well. And I thought that, man, this is the place to study. So that was like my first impression when I actually came to know about how great Australia is, how, you know, the education is, you know, separate from the rest of the world. And another aspect was like, I think I have a bit of family here. So that was another thing. But in terms of education and the facilities they provide to random citizens, to students, and I think that is world class. And apart from that, I had a look at a couple of courses in Canada and New Zealand as well. But they were actually of 1 year, 1.5 years. So, but the particular course I was looking for was only in Australia. And that too, further, I chose Perth because I think, you know, things are more favorable here. That's why.
Right, right. And I guess you entered in the February this year, right?
Yeah, February. That's right. Yeah.
And that was the most eventful intake, I guess. Right.
Absolutely, because that was like the final intake. Like nobody knew it at that time, but after that it was like a full shut off. Like my flight actually was on 15th February and 22nd February they actually locked down everything. So like if I would have been a week late, I wouldn't have, you know, gained access to enter into Australia. So that was a close situation for me.
Right. And I guess you know, around 15th of February, right, coronavirus was not so much widespread, right?
That's true.
It was there in China, Thailand, right?
Yeah.
So did you imagine that, you know, things could go this far? Or
I remember
the
day.
What was going on?
I mean, it was 22nd of December when I received my visa. And, you know, my dad out of nowhere in the morning, he told me that, you know, there's this virus going on in China. I thought, okay, I mean, I didn't give anything about it because I knew that, okay, how worse can it go? Then, you know, after a couple of days, it's starting spreading at a very fast pace. Then I looked at history and, okay, I found out a fact that, you know, every 20th year of the century, there is some pandemic or something that breaks
pandemic,
out.
So, yeah.
Then it started to, you know, settle in. Everybody was like, okay, it's only contained in China. And by the way, my flight was actually through Bangkok in Thai Airways. So the thing was, okay, I had a layover of about 1.5 hours, but that got extended to around 9 hours. So I had to take the next flight because of the quarantine checks and everything. So, I thought personally that, you know, how worse can it get? But, you know, when actually I came in Australia, my parents came to drop me off and they also went back at that very moment, because if they would have, you know, extended their stay, they couldn't have gone back either. So it was a very touch and go situation for me. I didn't think about it in the beginning, but, you know, as it got bigger and bigger, I kept feeling lucky for myself, like, okay, I made it finally, because otherwise I had to, you know, drop a whole year, which would have messed up my plans. So that was crucial for me.
Yes. And so how has the last 6 months been, right, with the online classes and all of that?
See, when I came in February, I had face-to-face classes till about April. And then actually May and June is exam season here. So actually I didn't go to the university because everything was pretty much online after that. So I think online classes are pretty convenient if you ask my opinion, because I think you can give your work a lot of time. You have a lot of flexibility in your timings. Like there is no rigid space for you to go that you have to be in the uni at that time. So, I mean, obviously people can contradict this statement that, okay, you are paying a lot of amount. You should go to the university and experience it on first-hand basis. But I didn't feel like there was a lot of difference, because I felt pretty comfortable with it, because the exams were online. That gives you an advantage that it was an open book test rather than a written paper. So that was an advantage to me and my friends and all the students here. But now as this semester is going on, we are going to the universities for regular classes. And I mean, according to the situation, I think it was justified. And my experience was pretty good.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And any idea when would the one-on-one offline classes would start?
For us already here, the students, they have already begun with their face-to-face classes.
Oh,
and,
okay.
Yeah, because our second semester started in August. And since August, we are going regularly to the classes. There is no quarantine, no restrictions in Perth, especially zero active cases. And the bare minimum 2 or 3 cases are only in hotel quarantine, that too, who have come from New Zealand or some other country. So yeah, since June, it's pretty much normal here. So like when I speak to my parents or my friends, they're like, man, you are going without a mask. You one lucky fellow. I was like, man, that's good. Plus uni experience has been good. And yeah.
Here, you know, mask has become so common, right? So
it's a part of your life now.
I just came back and Right. So we have one question from the chat, and we'll just take it up just a second. Question. I've scored 8 CGPA in 10th and graduation, and I've done good marks in PTE, but have very poor percentage in 12th. I want to go to MBA from Curtin, which is okay. So poor marks in 10th, poor marks in 12th. Would that affect the MBA? Admissions?
No, not really, because you know, if you're going for your master's program, your very recent result will be taken into consideration. So like whatever you did in bachelor's, that will have the effect on your, you know, getting into the university or getting any scholarship. But a 12th result doesn't matter as long as it is 50% and above, because that is the basic criteria which goes through across all universities, I guess. So as long as you are 50% and above in 12th, you have a good CGPA in 10th, but that won't really matter. And good marks in graduation and your English proficiency as well, I think you'll be fine. No issues with that.
Got it. So we have one, you know, quite big question, open-ended question, which is, you know, what was your admission process like? Like your entire, you know.
See, my bachelor's got over in July 2019. So I was actually planning to go in that intake itself. But the thing is, my degree got a bit late. The official degree, which comes from the IP university, so that got a bit late. So I had to defer my admission process. So the thing is, the first step is obviously you need to shortlist the universities. And by shortlisting, I don't mean that, you know, just go after ranks, because ranks don't really matter in Australia. I've, you know, talked about it in my YouTube videos as well, that ranks is only for, you know, just to keep the goodwill of the university. But let's say universities has a, you know, say, let's say it's in top 5 universities in Australia. But for your department, that's not really the case. So what I would suggest is look for a university which excels in your department, your field, shortlist that, apply for the offer letter, send all your documents. They take about 1 to 2 weeks to process that out. But because of this COVID thing, that might increase. I don't know how much. And once you get your offer letter, you just need to show your financial documents. And that again depends on you, that you're going for a scholarship or a sponsorship or you're self-financing that. Once you do that, obviously you'll have to give your IELTS result before actually applying for the visa. So you can do that before the offer letter as well. And even after that, that won't really matter. And once you have all this in line and everything gets approved, you will get a COE, which is your confirmation of enrollment. And after that, I think you just have to apply for the visa, get your medical done, apply for the overseas student healthcare cover, which is like a mandatory thing. And this whole process would roughly take about 6 months in normal circumstances. In the COVID thing, I really don't have any clue how much time it's taking these days. But as from what I've heard, the like visa processes are taking place, but the time frame has not been specified yet. So all the best to you, all the guys who are applying. Let's hope for the best.
Right. So, so we have a lot of questions in the chat, and we'll take up all of them one by one.
Yeah.
Right. Hey, Parth, did you work previously in India or did you join directly after your bachelor's?
Yes, I have joined directly after my bachelor's. I had just, I mean, as I told you, in July 2019, my degree got over. And in Feb 2020, I was here. But during my bachelor's, I had worked a lot of events, a lot of part-time work, a lot of internships. So that built up my resume. And that resume won't actually matter much. But here, if you want to find part-time work or casual jobs, that would really boost your chances. Because after this COVID thing, I don't think, you know, finding jobs is easy. Especially with international students and, you know, already like the government giving preference to the domestic people first. So it becomes a challenge for international students. But yeah, if you have worked during your college, any sort of work, like it could be a freelance work, it could be an NGO work. And NGOs are giving a lot of priority here. So if you have done those, it's good for you. It's good for you when you, you know, find a job in Australia.
Right. So on the same lines, I guess your job is quite exciting, I guess, your part-time job.
Right now, yeah, it's exciting. Actually, I was looking for work in some automobile industry because I have worked with Kia Motors back in India. But here, the employment doesn't work like that. You need to be in Australia for at least 12 months before you can actually apply in some automobile or some technical field. So I had a couple of friends who had good experience working at the bar where I work. So I think, yeah, he gave me reference as well. But otherwise, there was a personal interview. There was a hiring process. It's been good so far. Like the pay is decent and like it's not stressful at all, I think. Right, and as a student, you don't need extra stress over a university work. So I think that works the best for me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I guess the perks would also be quite good. So so we have a fan of yours over here. If you want to say hi.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, I'll say this again because the YouTube family is, you know, has grown at a great pace for me personally. Because when I came to Australia, I had no intention of just starting a channel. But I found out that there's no one in particular who's, you know, giving appraisal to Perth and its surroundings. So I thought like, because when I came here, I had no experience of Perth. No one was there to guide me. I just had my counselors and everything. But, you know, to get an experience from a person who's already been there really helps you a lot. And you know the inside outs of everything. And so, yeah, definitely I'll meet you. No worries. Hit me up when you come here. Yeah.
Right. So, okay. Can we get scholarship after joining university in coming semesters? I don't have good marks in 12th. I got 79s. So, yeah, what is the scene of scholarships?
The scholarships.
How difficult?
See, some universities which lie in a group of 8 in Australia, they give preference to IELTS score. Like if you're above 8, you can have a good chance of getting a scholarship, but that percentage will be low. Let's say about 5 to 10%. But if you are going to any university in the regional areas, you can get up to 25 to 30% scholarship based on your bachelor's score. So I would say it totally depends on the university, like what type of scholarship they're offering. Like if they're offering on merit basis, I would suggest you that you keep your score 75% and above in your graduation. And if your university is accepting English proficiency as a way of getting a scholarship, then I would suggest you keep it at least above 7.5 to have a chance. And some universities even collaborate on both of things. Like they don't entirely need your IELTS or they don't just entirely need your college marks as well. So again, it depends on what university are you planning out. They'll be probably the better ones to guide you.
So Parth, a lot of students have previously asked us, right, about the PR in Australia, right? So Kafi students who go abroad are looking for that PR, either in Canada or in Australia, right? So I know that you also have a video on that, right? PR in Australia versus Canada, right? And people usually perceive that PR in Australia is a bit difficult as compared to Canada. So if you could shed more light on that, and you know, is it actually true that, you know, PR in Australia is difficult as compared to Canada, or, you know, maybe it is difficult or easy for some courses and maybe not for others?
Yeah. So for your first part, is Australian PR easy or more difficult than Canada? It is definitely difficult than, you know, getting into Canada. I guess Canada, you know, has a favor in laws as well, has favor in the government as well for Indians. So technically, yeah, it becomes a bit easier. But from what I have experienced, I think, yeah, getting PR Australia is tough. But I won't say it is impossible. Like, I'll give an example. Like, you know, people ask me that if I come in an accountancy field or a marketing field or a sales field, I have just one reply. It depends upon, like, there's a skilled occupation list which comes out for every state in Australia. And according to that, you have to see that how high are the chances of getting a PR. Now, one misconception which people have that if your list is not in the SOL list, sorry, if a course is not in the SOL list, you cannot get a PR. But that's not the truth. It actually is a way of giving your preference. So let's say if my course is in the SOL list, I would get a preference over those courses or not. But that doesn't mean that those courses which are not in the SOL list, they are not eligible at all. So if you look at fields like accountancy and sales and marketing, they require a lot of points to get a PR. They can even go above 90, 95 points. And if you look at the fields like IT or nursing or healthcare or hotel management, they can even, you know, dip below till 65. Like telecommunication is a field which, you know, Australia has a lot of outsourcing power. So they do outsource a lot of people. And that's why the requirement for the telecommunication field is like barely 60. So I would say it depends on your course firstly. And then the preference, like, is that course in the SOL list? Yes or no? And then obviously depends on you as well. Like, let's say if a person has a great academic background, but he's not able to present himself against a company, then obviously wouldn't get hired. And if he's not hired, he can't get a PR. So even though his course was listed in the SOL list, he couldn't get a PR. So it depends to person on person. It depends on the course you're preferring. It depends on the field you are in. And that's pretty much it, because I don't think there's any other factor to it. But it's tougher than Canada, but I won't say it's impossible. And if you manage to get your points as well, then obviously they'll give you a PR. They don't have any something like they won't give you a PR. So it is a bit tough. It takes a lot of work. Like, I know in Canada, you can get a PR within 2 to 3 years. In Australia, it might take you up to 5 years. But if you do all the things in line, you will definitely get it.
Right. And I guess the region where you are in Australia, it also makes a difference in the case of, you know, if you're in a city like Sydney or in a regional area like Perth, for example, right? I guess Perth has, you know, currently Perth comes under the city category, or is no, it
actually
under
is,
the
it,
regional
it's a
one?
Right now, yeah.
Okay, right. So we have got a couple of questions on the same, you know, topic, which is city versus regional area. So city versus regional area in terms of part-time jobs and PR.
Because firstly, I'll talk about the part-time jobs.
Sure.
A very natural thing is like in Sydney, Melbourne, or Brisbane, the population is a lot. And if you need a part-time job in your specific field, like if you're rigid about a field, let's say if you're from an engineering background and you're looking for a part-time job in that pretty same field, it's definitely going to be tough. And similarly, getting a permanent job is going to be tough. And similarly, getting a PR is going to be tough. So I think all these three things are relational. Let's say in Perth, mining industry is at a boom. IT industry and information systems are technically at boom, because everywhere you go in Perth, there is automated machines, artificial intelligence, AI is everywhere. So it depends on the field and what region area does that, you know, the population is less compared to those big cities like Sydney and Melbourne, but everything else is the same. Let's say, like, I have lived in Perth, I have visited Sydney as well. Infrastructure-wise, it's the same. Technology-wise, it's the same. Living-wise, it's the same. Naturally, the cost of living is a bit less, but everything else is the same. So what I believe is, if you go to a regional area, you have more chances of getting a job which you like, more chances of getting a PR accordingly. And if you're in a regional area, you get 5 extra points for PR. So that obviously helps your cause as well. But again, saying it doesn't mean that, you know, you won't get a PR in Melbourne or Sydney. Totally depends on you. Totally depends on a field. I'm just saying the chances of getting a PR are higher in the regional area when you compare it to some top shop cities like Melbourne or Sydney.
Right. So, what was your main reason to select Perth as compared to, you know, Sydney, which you said you have visited before? Why Perth? Was it because of the regional area, or was it because of the university, or maybe something else?
Regional area was definitely one of the strong points which I had in mind, like, because my ultimate aim is obviously to get a PR like every other international student.
So one point
was that. Another point was I actually shortlisted a couple of universities before actually selecting Curtin. So I had two of them in Brisbane and one of them in Adelaide as well. But the same course they were offering were for 1.5 years. And I wouldn't have got a post-study work visa if my course is not for 2 years. So that was a big factor, because similar course were there in Brisbane. The fees was also comparatively less, but, you know, the duration was less and I wanted to stay here for work as well. So one reason was that. And apart from that, Curtin's business and law school are ranked in, you know, up among the top 1% in entire Australia and the top 10% in all around the world. So it's actually totally against the course. Like, it's up to my course. I found that this was my best bet, and I had reviews with a couple of Indian guys as well. A couple of guys who were from Spain and Mexico. They all were giving positive reviews about this particular course. And yeah, that's why I decided to go for it. Plus, it's in a regional area, so I do get a bit of rebate on the fees when compared to Sydney or Melbourne. So everything went in line, and I decided to go for this.
Right. Sounds good.
Yeah. Okay.
Right. So yeah. Does Australia accept 3 years of BSc computers for IT masters?
Yeah, as long as it's from a university which is recognized. That's a pretty strong point which people ask. Like, let's say from Delhi University, everybody knows, and IPU, everybody knows. So like, those two universities are recognized all over the world, and they do give you preference. But let's say if you have done it from a private college, I'm not going to take any name, but if you're doing it from a private college, they might, you know, question it. I won't say they'll reject it, but they might question it because it is not from a recognized government body. So that actually depends on your university, on the university you're going to select abroad, and accordingly, they'll give you the outcome. You can even ask the counselors about this, because they have, you know, in-depth knowledge about all the streams and all the courses. So they'll probably be the better ones to guide you.
Right. So, Parth, yaar, teri following bahut hai yaar, bahut fans hai tere. So we have one more fan.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Means a lot.
Right. So, okay. 78 weeks masters versus 92 weeks masters. So
78 is 1.5.
78, I guess, 1.5 year. 1.5 year, right?
As I mentioned earlier, अगर आप यार 2 साल से कम का कोर्स करोगे तो आपको पोस्ट स्टडी वर्क वीजा नहीं मिलेगा. Especially in Australia, I don't know about Canada or New Zealand. अगर वहाँ diploma कर लो तो वो दे देते हैं पोस्ट स्टडी वर्क वीजा. But Australia में minimum 2 साल आपको पढ़ना ही पड़ेगा if you need to work there. So I would suggest a 92 weeks one, because you'll get 2 years, and obviously you'll get 3 more years of work visa if you're in a regional area, and 2 years if you're in Sydney, Melbourne or Brisbane. So
Okay, got it. We have two questions of the same kind, right? The first one is bachelor's in IT plus business for the scope, obviously in Australia, right? And scope of IT courses in Perth.
Bro, in IT, मैं यही कहूँगा कि IT and business का जो combination है, that is here to stay for the future, and that's what I did. Like, अगर आप data analytics करते हो, something related to artificial intelligence, something related to information systems, क्योंकि Australia में यार अगर आप McDonald's भी जाते हो, they don't have cashiers, they have automatic machines for literally everything. Like, there is a rollout coming on, so everything is automated, and the future is built on IT. And यहाँ के जितने भी industries हैं, they outsource most of the work. So, like, अगर कंपनी के अगर कुछ लोग हैं जो सिर्फ छोटी शिफ्ट करते हैं, like 2 से 4 की जो शिफ्ट करते हैं, IT वाले लोग 12-12 घंटे की शिफ्ट भी करते हैं, एंड दे आर मिंटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ मनी. सो IT का स्कोप देखो ऑल ओवर ऑस्ट्रेलिया, आई एम नॉट जस्ट सेइंग पर्थ, सिडनी, मेलबर्न, कहीं भी चले जाओ, IT इज अ गुड कॉम्बिनेशन. IT प्लस बिजनेस इज अ मोर डेडली कॉम्बिनेशन, सो यू कैन लुक फॉरवर्ड टू इट.
राइट, ठीक है.
बिकॉज़ आजकल यार लोग ना, दे टेंड टू गेट पीपल हु आर, यू नो, डाइवर्स. अगर आप सिर्फ आईटी में हो या सिर्फ कॉमर्स में हो, यू माइट नॉट बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दैट. बट अगर उनको आप एक एसेट, अगर वो आपको एक एसेट समझते हैं दैट ही कैन डू गुड इन कॉमर्स एज वेल, एंड ही कैन इवन हैंडल द आईटी, सो डेफिनेटली दैट गिव्स यू एनर्जी.
और अब एजुकेशन कितनी अलग है इन टर्म्स ऑफ असाइनमेंट्स और होमवर्क्स और एग्जाम्स और क्लासेस?
इफ इंडिया इज नॉर्थ देन ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज साउथ, दैट्स व्हाट आई कैन मेक ऑफ इट. क्योंकि बैचलर्स में हमने यही पढ़ाया, असाइनमेंट्स पेपर पे लिख के दो, रट्टा मार के पास हो. थ्योरेटिकल नॉलेज इतनी, मतलब देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ थ्योरेटिकल नॉलेज, बट प्रैक्टिकल में बंदे नहीं यूज कर पाते. लाइक इंडिया में आजकल रिसेंटली ना, ऑनलाइन इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड स्टॉक ब्रोकिंग का बहुत ज्यादा वो चल रहा है कोरोना के बाद से, कोविड के बाद से. तो उनको थ्योरेटिकल नॉलेज तो है, बट अनलेस आप प्रैक्टिकल उसको देखोगे यार, आप नहीं समझ पाओगे. यू विल नो द वर्किंग. आपको मैं गियर का क्रोनोलॉजी समझा दूं, बट अनलेस यू सी इट इन मोशन, आप कोई सेंस नहीं बना पाओगे उसकी. सो व्हाट रियली सेपरेट्स ऑस्ट्रेलिया फ्रॉम इंडिया इज कि ऑस्ट्रेलिया में हर चीज प्रैक्टिकल है. वी डोंट हैव बुक्स, पहली चीज. वी ऑल हैव पीडीएफ्स, उसमें रियल लाइफ एग्जांपल्स होते हैं. फॉर माय सब्जेक्ट वी हैव रियल लाइफ केस स्टडीज, एंड केस स्टडीज भी ऐसी हैं, लाइक आप उसका पूरा सिनेरियो समझो. देन आप एक अपनी कंपनी बनाओ, सेट इट फ्रॉम ए टू जेड, तो दैट ऑन हैंड एक्सपीरियंस जो आपको एक्चुअल में प्रैक्टिकल नॉलेज मिलती है वो आपको ऐसा बना देती है कि अगर आज आपका कॉलेज खत्म हो रहा है तो नेक्स्ट डे यू कैन गो एंड स्टार्ट अप योर ओन कंपनी, नेक्स्ट डे यू कैन गो एंड डिजाइन ओन डेटाबेस फॉर योरसेल्फ. सो आई थिंक दैट इज वेरी गुड. आई मीन आई रिस्पेक्ट दिस थिंग. And it's is, I mean, is, I'm yes. sure Canada and New Zealand, हर जगह यही सिस्टम होगा. But right. yeah, I feel it's really, really good. And assignments का भी यही सीन है. Everything is online. And everything is practical based. तो cheating and रट्टेबाजी का भाई कुछ नहीं हो सकता. You have to use your brain. And plagiarism is a very big thing here. अगर आपका 1-2% भी किसी से match होता है, they'll straightforward just you know strike it off. So it's a bit strict. It's a bit stressful as well. जैसे हम भी अगर assignment बनाने बैठते हैं तो भाई 10-10, 12-12 दिन लगातार बनाते हैं. उनकी वेटेज भी ज्यादा होती है. बट आई थिंक इट जस्ट डेवलप्स यू, यू गेट यूज्ड टू इट वंस यू स्टार्ट डूइंग इट एंड ऑब्वियसली इट्स बेनिफिशियल फॉर यू.
राइट. और आई गेस इंडिया में तो असाइनमेंट टेप नहीं है, मोस्ट स्टूडेंट्स कोई ये कर लेता है और बाकी सब टेप पे रहते
हैं. तो वही है ना, इंडिया में आप काम कर रहे हो जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ डूइंग. यहाँ पे आप कर रहे हो, अगर आपको मजबूरी में भी करना पड़ रहा है, यू आर एटलीस्ट लर्निंग, कुछ तो आपके सर में घुस ही रहा है. बिकॉज यू आर फ्रेमिंग इट एंटायरली योरसेल्फ, आप किसी की हेल्प नहीं ले रहे. यू कांट यूज विकिपीडिया, you can use articles, you can use journals from Harvard, but usse aapke dimag mein kuch ja raha hai, you are not just copying and pasting and stuff. So that definitely you know helps you learning and develop your overall skills.
Bilkul bilkul. Right okay. Acha, to on the same lines, agar if you went back 4 years, right, would you choose to do your bachelor's also from Australia, agar choice hota?
If I was
with all will agar, all the insights which you have today, right?
I would have selected it actually kyunki mera abroad jaane ka plan, I guess 11th 12th mein kind of like frame out hona start ho gaya tha, but I didn't know which is the right destination for me. So firstly I discussed it with my parents as well ki you know bachelor ke baad jana ke baad fayda hai ya masters ke baad jane ka fayda hai. But what I found out is my bachelor's agar main India se karu ya main Australia se karu, that won't really matter jab main masters karunga. Because masters would be my recent qualification, so no one is going to look at my bachelor's. That's what at least happens in Australia. So I would have shared, you know, double the money I'm spending on my master's. If I had done my bachelor's here, student loan extra lena padta tha, that would have been, you know, pretty heavy for me. But I guess, abhi jo mereko insights hai, I would still do my bachelor's in India because firstly, you know, finance aapka save ho jata hai. Apart from that, I don't think ki jo, at least maine jo wahan knowledge seekhi hai, that is actually helping me out. Kyunki kuch marketing jaise subjects the, जो यहाँ पे मेरे को कनेक्टेड लगते हैं. इकोनॉमिक्स थोड़ी, इंडिया का आपको इकोनॉमिक्स पता, लाइक इट्स नॉट वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, इट्स नॉट अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग इकोनॉमिकली डेवलप्ड कंट्री. तो आप इजीली यहाँ के कंपैरिजन फ्रेम आउट कर सकते हो दैट व्हाट इज अ कंट्री लैकिंग बिहाइंड इन, व्हाट इज दिस, व्हाट इज द मोटिव ऑफ द कंट्री हियर. सो आई थिंक मैं बैचलर्स इंडिया से ही करता, कीपिंग ऑल द थिंग्स इन माइंड. एंड मास्टर्स ऑब्वियसली दिस इज अ नेक्स्ट लेवल, अगर आप इंडिया से कंपेयर करो तो इट्स गुड.
So, what is the scope of psychology in Australia?
Bro, I don't have any idea about psychology to be honest. But यहाँ पे जितने भी courses, like इसको ऐसा zoom करो कि यहाँ पे कोई course छोटा नहीं है. क्योंकि अगर आप अपने field में excel कर दे तो यहाँ पे jobs हैं और हर field की jobs हैं. यहाँ पे लोग normal वो भी करने आते हैं, like cookery के courses करने आते हैं, which is just about knowing utensils and all, utensils की knowledge कि what type of spoon is this, what type of plate is that. सिर्फ उनको भी they get highly paid jobs in you know hotels like Ritz Carlton and everything. So koi bhi course main ye nahi bolunga ki bekar hai ya fir nahi karo aap, cause jisme aapka interest hai wo karo. Cause agar main aapko bol dun ki accounting mein aapki top shot job lag jayegi, aapka interest hi nahi hai usme, so how is that going to help you? Aap zindagi bhar wahi job karte rahoge, you will be like main thoda kam kama lunga but koi aur job kar lunga. So that thing actually happens. So I won't say, matlab I would say that agar aapka psychology mein interest hai, you go for it. And you have, if you are excelling in that field, then यार कोई नहीं रोक सकता तुम्हें, जॉब वॉब पे कोई सीन नहीं है.
ऑल गुड. ठीक है, बढ़िया. तो ऐसे कुछ कोर्सेज तो होंगे ना जहाँ पे मतलब काफी हाई चांस है कि पीआर मिल जाए, काफी हाई चांस है कि पार्ट टाइम जॉब मिल जाए इन दैट फील्ड, या फिर यू नो, तो वो कौन से कोर्सेज है?
देखो अगर आप कैरी ऑन द लिस्ट,
काफी बच्चे आते हैं वो बोलते हैं हमें पता नहीं कि हमारा इंटरेस्ट क्या है, राइट? हमें बस ये कोर्स बना बता दो जिसका स्कोप हो, ठीक है? और अगर 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 3-4 कोर्सेज बोल दो कि देन वी चूज अमंग दोस 4 कि हाँ हमारा उन चारों में से काम पे सबसे ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट है, बट वी स्पेसिफिकली डोंट हैव यू नो इंटरेस्ट इन एनी पर्टिकुलर फील्ड.
सो फर्स्टली देखो, पार्ट टाइम जॉब अगर आप स्टडीज के साथ प्लान कर रहे हो तो वो आपको अपने फील्ड में मिलना इज प्रीटी टफ, क्योंकि अनलेस आपके पास डिग्री होगी आपको एक्चुअली में जॉब पे नहीं रखेगा. सो लाइक आई ऑल्सो ट्राइड फॉर ऑटोमोबाइल, मेरे को उसमें नहीं मिली बिकॉज द नीड एक्सपीरियंस. हाँ, अगर आप इंडिया में एक्सपीरियंस लेके आ रहे हो देन इट्स टोटली डिफरेंट थिंग. अगर आपके पास इंडिया में एक्सपीरियंस ग्रेटर देन 3 years है देन आप किसी भी फील्ड में आप पार्ट टाइम जॉब ले सकते हो. एंड इफ यू आस्क मी, लाइक लोग मुझसे पूछते हैं कि हाउ इज द स्कोप ऑफ एमबीए, क्योंकि इंडिया में क्या आई थिंक कि एवरीबॉडी वांट्स टू डू एमबीए. लाइक एमबीए इज अ वेरी मेनस्ट्रीम थिंग इन इंडिया. लाइक हर बंदे से
क्वाइट कॉमन, फाइनेंस
ऑपरेशंस मार्केटिंग ऑल दीस थिंग्स आर वेरी कॉमन. दैट्स द सेम थिंग हियर. यहां से अगर आप एमबीए कर भी लोगे ना, यू वोंट बी एट दैट लेवल बिकॉज एमबीए इज प्रीटी कॉमन दीस डेज. तो एमबीए से हटना है आपको अगर एंड सेम फील्ड में जाना है तो मास्टर्स करो इन कॉमर्स और इन सम मैनेजमेंट फील्ड जिसमें एमबीए के ना कुछ एलिमेंट्स हो. Like there is one course called Global MBA. उसमें आपको exposure ज़्यादा मिलता है. It's like an MBA, but it has a bit more technicality into it. तो आपको उस field में ज़्यादा मिल सकता है. Data related जितने भी courses हों, data science, databases, data analytics, information systems, programming. Programming has a lot of scope in Australia. क्योंकि यहाँ पे as I said, everything is automatic. So these fields, मतलब IT sector में तो no doubts आपको jobs मिलेंगी. Law is good. बट लॉ में आपको इशू क्या होगा कि लाइक जो इंडिया से लॉ करके आ रहा होगा ही वुड हैव द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ इंडियन लॉ इनटू हिज माइंड. तो उसको आई वुड सजेस्ट कि यहाँ पे आपको एक बार आके आप डिप्लोमा करो पहले इन द सेम फील्ड सो दैट यू गेट टू यूज टू द लॉ इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड देन यू कैन फर्दर गो इनटू दैट. एंड ऑब्वियसली बिजनेस एंड मैनेजमेंट कोर्सेज आर ऑलवेज एट द बूम, क्योंकि यहाँ पे बिजनेसेस एज कंपैरेटिवली टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड कम है. सो इफ यू आर डूइंग सम ट्रेड कोर्सेज एंड सेटिंग अप योर ओन बिजनेस और समथिंग, उसका भी बहुत स्कोप है. So and even nursing at least Western Australia mein nursing is like one of the highest paid jobs. Maine to bahut log dekhe hain, like random log jaise main kabhi kuch lene ja raha hu, what you are doing, kyunki yahan pe pehli baar to shops mein usually na students employed hote hain part time and casual
work.
Like you won't find any old staff in the shops. To unse randomly kabhi baat hoti hai to most of the people are saying I'm doing nursing, I'm doing hotel management, I'm doing cookery. So har course ki demand hai, but it's again in the end it's here individual to individual depend karta hai actually. But these 4 to 5 segments have actually a lot of scope in Australia. Nursing, business management, IT, hotel management is also good.
Hospitality ka jo bhi hota hai, right?
Hospitality and all that stuff. And sports mein zara jaise log mujhse puchta ki how is the scope of sports, ki log cricket and tennis and in sab ke bare mein puchte hain. So yaar agar aap India mein koi top shot player reh chuke ho and yahan aake county cricket or county football start karte ho, so that is also a good thing. क्योंकि यहाँ पे स्पोर्ट्स को इज लाइक द टॉप थिंग. लाइक सिर्फ क्रिकेट नहीं, फुटबॉल, सारे स्पोर्ट्स होते हैं. बट इफ यू आर लुकिंग फॉर अ करियर इन स्पोर्ट्स यू कैन, बट आप यू हैव टू बी एट योर बेस्ट, क्योंकि यहाँ पे ऑलरेडी जनता बहुत है. स्पोर्ट्स इज अ गुड ऑप्शन, बट हाँ अगर आप इंडिया में एक प्रॉपर डोमेस्टिक लेवल या स्टेट लेवल पे खेल चुके हो देन ऑब्वियसली यू कैन गो अहेड एंड उसमें भी स्कोप मिल सकता है.
ठीक है, तो इंडिया में ना काफी कॉलेज, मतलब इंडिया में देयर इज अ नॉर्म कि हाँ कॉलेज में प्लेसमेंट तो हो ही जाएगा, राइट? कॉलेज हमें प्लेसमेंट दे देगा, राइट? सो इज दैट आल्सो द केस इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया, राइट? एनी काइंड ऑफ प्लेस,
ना दे डोंट प्रोवाइड यू प्लेसमेंट्स, बट व्हाट दे हैव इज दे हैव एजुकेशन फेयर्स दैट टेक प्लेस एवरी 6 months. तो एजुकेशन फेयर्स में क्या होती है, कंपनीज आती है, दे गेट टू नो सम रैंडमली पिक आउट पीपल फ्रॉम एनी क्लास, देखते हैं कि हाउ इज द पर्सन एंड आप खुद भी अप्लाई कर सकते हो, दैट इज अप टू यू. बट दे कैन गिव यू एन इंटर्नशिप, दे कैन गिव यू अ पार्ट टाइम एक्सपोजर, बट जॉब्स कैंपस वाले आपको लाइक इट्स लाइक जीरो हेल्प फ्रॉम देम. यू हैव टू बिल्ड योर ओन रेज्यूमे, यू हैव टू बिल्ड योर ओन पर्सनैलिटी एंड आपको जाके अप्लाई करना ही पड़ेगा. कैंपस प्लेसमेंट वाला कोई सीन नहीं है. बट वॉट आई डू सजेस्ट यू इज की अगर आपको कोई पार्ट टाइम वर्क मान लो नहीं मिल रहा, ठीक है, तो जस्ट से टू एम्प्लॉयर की आप मुझे काम पे रख लो, जस्ट कीप मी फॉर 3 to 5 weeks, सी माई वर्क, मेरे को बेशक उस पीरियड में पैसे मत देना, जस्ट टेक इट लाइक एज अ प्रोबेशन पीरियड, एंड अगर आपको मेरा काम पसंद आता है सो यू हायर मी. तो उससे क्या होता है, एम्प्लॉयर भी सोचता है कि ठीक है मेरा काम भी हो रहा है, आई एम नॉट इवन पेइंग हिम, एंड इफ आई फाइंड हिज वर्क यूजफुल देन ऑब्वियसली आई विल हायर हिम. सो कैंपस प्लेसमेंट्स का जो एक आइडियोलॉजी है दैट डजंट वर्क हियर. यू हैव टू बी ऑन योर ओन अबाउट दैट, क्योंकि हम भी कोविड के चक्कर में पहले बिल्कुल जॉब्स नहीं थी. आई सर्च आउट फॉर जॉब, ऑनलाइन अप्लाई भी बहुत किया बट टू नो सक्सेस. देन शुरू में थोड़ा स्ट्रगल करने के बाद जुलाई तक अपनी जॉब फाइनल हुई, तब से अभी स्मूथ चल रहा सारा.
अच्छा, तो ऐसा भी होता है कि थोड़े बच्चों को पार्ट टाइम जॉब नहीं मिलती है, ऐसा भी है या फिर सबको मिल जाती है?
देखो इनिशियली ढूंढना आपको ना आना चाहिए, लाइक पहले तो डिसाइड कर लो कि आपको लाइक कैसी जॉब चाहिए, क्योंकि हर जगह जॉब्स हैं, बट यू नीड टू डिसाइड वेयर यू वांट टू वर्क. जैसे कुछ लोग होते हैं वो कहते हैं कि मुझे डिश वॉशिंग क्लीनिंग और ये बहुत ही लो लेवल जॉब्स नहीं करनी, किसी का माइंडसेट होता है लोगों का, तो देन आई वुड सजेस्ट यू कि आप रिज्यूमे का 10-12 प्रिंट आउट निकालो, शॉप टू शॉप जाके जस्ट आस्क देम इफ देयर इज एनी वैकेंसी, एंड अगर वैकेंसी नहीं भी है जस्ट से देम आप मेरा रिज्यूमे रखो, जब वैकेंसी आएगी मुझे तब कॉन्टैक्ट कर लेना. एंड आई हैव हैड रिवर्ट्स फ्रॉम सम ऑफ द शॉप, जैसे नैंडोज काफी फेमस चेन है, तो अगर कभी उनको हायरिंग चाहिए होगी दिल उनके डोर पे लिखा होगा वी आर हायरिंग नाउ इंक्वायर एट द काउंटर. सो जॉब्स आती रहती हैं जाती रहती हैं, क्योंकि जो भी कैजुअल जॉब करता है नाउ कैजुअल जॉब इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम पार्ट टाइम जॉब, बंदे का मन करेगा वो आएगा, बंदे का मन करेगा वो नहीं आएगा, टोटली अप टू द पर्सन. तो उन सिनेरियोज में फास्ट फूड रेस्टोरेंट्स में आपको जॉब्स मिल सकती हैं, लाइक डोमिनोज, अगर आप ऑस्ट्रेलिया की बात करो डोमिनोज में आपको 90% इंडियन स्टाफ दिखेगा, इंडिया और फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान और फ्रॉम श्रीलंका, तो उनमें आपका चांस है. इफ यू हैव रेफरेंस देन आपके लिए और बेटर है. देन अगर आपको लाइक इट डिपेंड्स आपको कैसी जॉब करनी है, क्लीनिंग जॉब्स तो इजीली मिल जाती हैं, दे वोंट पे यू वेल, बट स्टार्टिंग में अगर आपके पास कुछ नहीं है एंड यू हैव टू स्टार्ट समवेयर, देन आई वुड सजेस्ट कि यार रेस्टोरेंट्स में जाके पूछो, किसी ना कहीं तो स्टाफ चाहिए होगा उनको. इवन सम रिटेलर्स जैसे जो क्लोथिंग शॉप्स होती हैं उनको भी स्टाफ चाहिए होता है, स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग द समर्स, क्योंकि यहाँ की समर्स में बहुत फेस्टिवल्स आते हैं, न्यू ईयर फेस्टिवल, क्रिसमस फेस्टिवल, बॉक्सिंग डे फेस्टिवल्स, उसके उस टाइम पे ऑलरेडी यू नो जॉब्स की वो ज्यादा होती है, डिमांड ज्यादा होती है, सो यू कैन इजीली फाइंड वर्क. बट जब मैं आया था वही कोविड की सिचुएशन थी, इट वॉज अ बिट टफ. सॉरी, यहाँ पे ना पोलन वाला वो सीजन चल रहा है, सो एवरीबॉडी इज कफिंग एंड स्नीजिंग. तो अगर आप आ रहे हो, अगर आपका कुछ नहीं है तो ब्रो ऊबर इज योर बेस्ट बेट. ऊबर में पैसे भी अच्छे हैं, लाइक इट्स डिसेंट, इट्स नॉट मच, बट ऊबर का कोई भी कर सकता है, यू जस्ट गेट अ साइकिल, स्टार्ट ऊबर इट्स.
और अभी तो तुषार ने भी काफी वीडियोस बनाए हैं.
हां, आई हैव सीन दैट. या
तुषार ने काफी वीडियोस बनाए ऊबर में, साइकिल लेके निकल लेता है.
हां, हमने भी यही किया था, बिकॉज़ इनिशियली वी थॉट कि यार जॉब तो मिल ही जाएगी, हर किसी का प्रसेप्शन यही होता है कि जॉब मिल जाएगी, $30 पर घंटे मिल जाएंगे, 20 घंटे काम कर लेंगे, बट दैट्स नॉट द केस. ग्राउंड रियलिटी थोड़ी डिफरेंट है. बट या ऊबर इट्स इज गुड फॉर इनिशियल स्टेज, बट ऐसा नहीं है कि यार आप उस पर सस्टेन कर सकते हो. Unless you have a vehicle and you're doing it in a car, then it's a different thing. But initially, if you don't have a car, ke paise nahi hai, you can just buy off a cycle and uspe Uber Eats kar lo, and it'll give you good money.
Right. Yeh toh ek kaafi interesting baat boli tune ki yahan pe aake pata chalta hai ki yaar, you know, 20 hours job maybe na mile, $20 per hour maybe na mile, right? So students have some kind of a mental model ki Australia ke yehi hoga.
Expect in reality.
And they're traveling to Australia for the studies.
अब हाँ, पहली बात तो देखो, हर बंदा सोचता है कि we can work 20 hours a week. ठीक है, 20 hours a week लगता है कि आपको हर जगह जॉब मिल जाएगी, but many employers don't give you that 20 hours a week thing. तो अगर आप सोच के बैठो कि अगर मेरे को 20 घंटे भी मिल रहे हैं, sorry 20 घंटे मिल रहे हैं और $20 में पर घंटे कमा रहा हूँ, 400 easily हो जाएंगे, but that's not the case. पैसे हो सकता है कुछ ज्यादा मिल जाए, बट पूरे 20 घंटे के employer से करना sometimes can get a bit tough. तो एक्सपेक्ट करो कि आपको 10 से 12 घंटे मिलेंगे लीगली आपको काम करना है, तो बाकी कैश इन हैंड जॉब्स होती हैं, बट यू डू दैट ऑन योर ओन रिस्क, कभी पकड़े गए तो सीधा भाई डिपोर्ट हो जाओगे, सो दैट्स अ बिग रिस्क. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट महंगी है सिटी ऑब्वियसली, अगर आप शुरू में अर्निंग नहीं कर रहे होगे एंड सिर्फ मॉम डैड या पेरेंट्स से मंगा रहे होगे तो बहुत ज्यादा लोड होगा, बिकॉज इनिशियली क्या होता है, हर बंदा कन्वर्ट करता है भाई, $4 अच्छा इतने रुपए हो गए, $100 अच्छा इतने रुपए हो गए, सो उस मेंटालिटी को आपको हटाना पड़ेगा, बिकॉज हर बार कन्वर्ट करता रहोगे सो यू वोंट बी एबल टू लिव योर लाइफ, कुछ भी नहीं खरीद पाओगे यार, दूध का कार्टन भी $3 का आएगा तो तुम बोलोगे ₹150 का है, तो सो दैट वोंट हेल्प योर कॉज. तो मनी फाइनेंस शुरू में टाइट होता है, बट यू गेट यूज टू इट, हम सोचते हैं इतनी दिक्कत नहीं होगी, बट हाँ एक्सपेंसिव है. अकोमोडेशन का रेंट सबसे ज्यादा आपका पैसा खाएगा अगर आप अर्न नहीं कर रहे हो तो आई वुड से पहली चीज तो यू हैव टू लुक फॉर अ जॉब, क्योंकि डिपेंडिंग अपॉन योर पेरेंट्स यू कांट यू नो सस्टेन ऑन दैट, क्योंकि फीस भी आपकी आई गेस लोन या कुछ निकाल देगा, बट पर्सनल एक्सपेंसेस यू विल हैव टू कैटर इट समहाउ. और मिसकंसेप्शन और है यार, खाना यू मिस योर फूड वहां का, क्योंकि यहाँ पे इंडियन फूड अगर रेस्टोरेंट से मंगाओगे तो इट विल बी प्रीटी एक्सपेंसिव, खुद बनाओगे तो जो रॉ मटेरियल्स लोगे वो भी थोड़ा एक्सपेंसिव होते हैं, सो यू गेट यूज्ड टू इट आफ्टर सम टाइम, बट इनिशियली याद आती है, यू टेंड टू फील होमसिक एज वेल, मॉम के हाथ के पराठे एंड ऑल दैट स्टफ, बट मेजरली आई थिंक योर फाइनेंस वुड बी द मेन थिंग, जो आके आपको झटका सा लगेगा कि यार बहुत ज्यादा खर्चा हो रहा है. सेकेंडली जॉब आपको लगेगा कि बहुत इजीली मिल सकती है, बट दैट्स नॉट द केस, यू विल हैव टू वर्क फॉर इट. एंड अकोमोडेशन इज अगेन अ थिंग, रेंट थोड़ा यू नो इज अ बिट मोर. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट एज सच चैलेंजेस अगर मैं याद करूँ तो आई डोंट थिंक कोई है, क्योंकि we live actually in the midst of the city, तो किसी भी चीज में दिक्कत नहीं हुई, everything is at a walking distance, so all's good, and बाकी convenience काफी ज़्यादा है, so there'll be like more convenient things rather than more difficulties, तो आपको इतना feel नहीं होगा, but these three four things you just keep in mind before coming here.
Right, okay, awesome. So we'll take three four more questions and we'll end the live in the next 5 minutes, guys. ठीक है? So जो जो भी है questions उस post them in the comments, right? And we actually do have a lot of questions already. So okay, so first,
thank you to all my YouTubers. तुम्हारी वजह से channel चल रहा है, so yeah, keep right. updated.
Okay, so what is coupon हो रहे हैं students के लिए?
यार ये this thing has been kept you know delaying for a lot of time now, क्योंकि as I said in my previous videos की Australia ना phases में खोलता अपने borders. So they were technically like phase one was the COVID thing, phase three was like the middle thing, and phase five was the absolutely open thing. So July mein unhone kaha tha ki that within the next 2 months we'll open the borders domestically, and then further 2 months baad hum international borders khol denge. And as of today, unhone domestic borders bhi nahi khole hain. Like even though northern territory, southern Australia, western Australia, they don't have any cases, they still haven't opened the interstate borders. Aap Perth ke bahar by road nahi ja sakte, and flights to bandi hain. So what I have perceived that September में उन्होंने बोला था that we'll be having a budget, तो इनका last week Australia का budget आया था, in which they have said that the borders opening actually depends on the COVID vaccine coming or not coming. So like they have two plans, plan A and plan B. Let's say if the COVID vaccine comes out by mid July of next year, they'll open the borders and then they'll execute plan A. Let's say if the vaccine doesn't come out, they won't open the borders and execute the plan B. So can't really comment on it, but at least you got to wait till December of this year. क्योंकि दिसंबर में फाइनल वर्डिक्ट आएगा बिफोर द क्लोजर ऑफ दिस ईयर, तो मे बी दैट विल गिव अस अ बिट मोर क्लैरिटी. बट पायलट प्रोग्राम्स चल रहे हैं, लाइक साउथ ऑस्ट्रेलिया में देयर इज अ पायलट प्रोग्राम गोइंग ऑन टू गेटिंग 300 स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम सिंगापुर. डार्विन में भी लाइक 50-60 स्टूडेंट्स आ रहे हैं इन स्मॉल सेगमेंट्स, बट अगर आप इंडिया की बात करो तो भाई उनका नंबर काफी लेट आएगा. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इन जनरल फॉर इंटरनेशनल स्टूडेंट्स, सो या दे आर टारगेटिंग मलेशियंस, सिंगापुर पीपल, थाईलैंड से लोग आना चाह रहे हैं. But if you're specifically speaking about Indian students and they're coming to Australia, I think like it's not a very positive thing, but at least wait till December to get a more clear verdict on that.
Right. Because
December official statement aayegi and they'll help us out.
So even if we have a vaccine, right, it would take, you know, a third quarter of 21 to
be available
reach,
everywhere.
Yes. So does it mean that Feb 21 intake nahi hoga?
That's the way things look like, but again I said ki December mein final verdict aayega, so I can't really you know say anything about it. Kyunki intakes to dekho July intake bhi hua tha and log aaye hain, but not from India. So if that question is only in regards to international students, to jaise New Zealand se log aa rahe hain, Tasmania apna hi hai but thoda niche hai, wahan se bhi log aa rahe hain borders close karke. Papua New Guinea se log aaye hain for but in small numbers, jaise jahan 30-35 thousand students aate the per semester, wahan sirf kuch 400 ya 500 aa rahe hain, so you can see how you know how much the decline is. So I won't say it is cancelled out, plus intakes ke liye maine students ko ye bhi recommend kiya tha ki aap ek semester online kar lo, and let's say if the things get you know better by July 21, then obviously you can fly here. Wo us case mein agar aapko apna time save karna hai, like agar aapko ek saal drop hi karna, so I would suggest ki yaar find a work in a country so that you can justify that gap. क्योंकि यूनिवर्सिटीज को लगेगा कि यार एक साल से घर पे बैठा हुआ, सो दे वोंट गिव यू प्रेफरेंस, एंड वो एक अलग इशू बन जाता है स्टडी गैप का. सो इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू मेक योरसेल्फ इन फेब 21, दैट आई वुड सजेस्ट कि आप कोई काम ढूंढ लो, बिकॉज आई विल जस्ट से कि वेट टिल 18th और 19th ऑफ दिसंबर, तब तक कुछ फाइनल वर्डिक्ट आएगा, उसके पहले आई कांट रियली से एनीथिंग ऑन दैट.
राइट,
क्योंकि जुलाई में तो एवरीबॉडी वाज सेइंग इवन नवंबर इनटेक वुड हैपन, बट like
but that is not
cases June se nahi hai, but they have been you know lingering on to open their borders. Jab tak pura Australia mein zero cases nahi ho jate, they won't even open the interstate borders, so international borders you know uska to abhi filhal koi scene nahi hai as of now.
Right.
But yeah, let's see in December.
Acha.
Yeah,
theek hai. To jaldi se ye dekh lete hain. I drew your and Ankit's vector drawing, please check the IG. Acha.
ओके जस्ट टेल मी कितने टाइम पहले भेजा था, बिकॉज़ बहुत सारी रिक्वेस्ट पड़ी हैं। आई हैव टू फिल्टर योर नेम डाउन, सो या आई विल डेफिनेटली फाइंड आउट, आई विल कीप योर नेम इन
हाँ
माइंड, एंड
हाँ हाँ हाँ
या आई विल डेफिनेटली लुक फॉरवर्ड एंड रिप्लाई यू
गुड।
बैक।
तो मास्टर्स आफ्टर अ फ्यू बैकलॉग्स इन अंडरग्रेड,
इफ
डज
यू
इट
हैव
अफेक्ट?
क्लियर देम, यू हैव टू क्लियर देम, दैट्स द मतलब अगर आप फेल हो दैट्स नो वरीज, बट मेक श्योर यू अगर लास्ट सेमेस्टर तक क्लियर हो जाए वो, क्योंकि अगर कोई बैकलॉग होगी तो दे वॉन्ट यू नो एक्सेप्ट योर एप्लीकेशन।
Just a second.
या नाउ इट्स फाइन। I think they have lost the connection, I guess.
Yes, I guess I'm back.
Yeah. Yeah, what happened, bro?
My I don't know, नेट का इशू हो गया था थोड़ा।
अच्छा, कोई इंडिया में होता रहता है, दैट्स फाइन, नो वरीज।
फॉर सितंबर 21 व्हेन शुड आई स्टार्ट माय एप्लीकेशन? आईएलटीएस कब देना चाहिए वगैरह?
एटलीस्ट 6 months प्रायर तो टाइम फ्रेम लेके चलो, बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड यू सारी चीजें लेट हो रही हैं। सो जैसे मैंने भी जुलाई में अप्लाई करना था इनिशियली, आई गेव माय आईएलटीएस इन नवंबर 2018, सो यू कैन सी कितना पहले मैंने दिया था सारे चीज़ों को माइंड में रखते हुए। सो आई थिंक 6 months वुड बी फाइन, बट हाँ 6 months शुड बी यू नो मोर देन इनफ, क्योंकि आप आइल्स दोगे देन ऑफर लेटर एंड ऑल सारा प्रोसेस वीजा तक 6 months के अंदर हो जाना चाहिए, सो दैट विल बी गुड।
ओके ठीक है। सो आर देयर एनी परमानेंट रीजनल एरियाज? डू वी नीड
परमानेंट
कैलकुलस इन
एज
आईटी?
इन परमानेंट रीजनल एरियाज आर अंडरस्टैंड, लाइक सी रीजनल एरियाज अभी जो हैं वो गारंटी नहीं है कि नेक्स्ट ईयर रहेंगे या नहीं रहेंगे। आई थिंक यू मीन दैट कि जो अभी रीजनल एरिया है क्या वो परमानेंट रीजनल एरिया रहेगा। सो थिंग्स कैन चेंज, बट योर एडवांटेजेस की मान लो आप 2020 में आए हो इन इन सम सिटी विच इज अ रीजनल एरिया, एंड इवन इफ इट लेट्स से नेक्स्ट ईयर वो रीजनल एरिया से हट जाती है, सो फॉर यू वो रीजनल एरिया ही रहेगी, आपको वर्क परमिट भी रीजनल एरिया के हिसाब से ही मिलेगा एंड यू विल गेट द एवरीथिंग, बट जो नेक्स्ट इनटेक में आ रहा होगा थिंग्स वुड चेंज फॉर हिम। एंड सेकेंडली डू वी नीड कैलकुलस इन आई टी? नो यार, आई डोंट थिंक यू नीड कैलकुलस इन आई टी, क्योंकि आई नेवर लाइक कैलकुलस टू बी ऑनेस्ट, एंड यहाँ पे नहीं है मेरे पास, सो आई एम रिलीव्ड फॉर दैट। इट्स बेसिकली आपको कैलकुलेशन ऑल करनी होती है, बट दे आर प्रीटी बेसिक, सारा कंप्यूटर वाला कैलकुलेशन होती है, कोडिंग एंड एवरीथिंग. सो यू नीड अ स्ट्रॉन्ग कोडिंग, यू विल नीड अ गुड नॉलेज ऑफ डेटाबेसिस एंड एवरीथिंग. बट हाँ, मैथ्स की एज सच कोई ज्यादा नीड नहीं होगी, अनलेस यू आर गोइंग इनटू द अकाउंटेंसी एंड फाइनेंस फील्ड्स.
राइट, ठीक है. So I'm pursuing bachelor's of commerce from Delhi University. Will master's in business analytics be a good option given the fact that I'm from commerce background? So I guess we're talking about, you know, commerce plus IT ka jo hota mixture.
हाँ, business analytics भी यहाँ पे काफी तरीके के मिल सकते हैं. Analytics can be, और एक ना यहाँ पे एक stream आती है जिसमें आप ना customer behavior समझते हो, कि अगर आपकी कोई let's clothing brand है, Zara और H&M something, आप customer का behavior notice करते हो and you make calculations based on some certain figure that how is likely is to come back, chahe usne koi purchase na ki ho, there is a proper study on that. To uska mere ko naam nahi pata, I'll share in my next video agar mujhe yaad aaya. To you can go for that, that is also comes you know under business analytics, and I think it's a good course kyunki anything related to data, statistics, analytics, yahan pe bahut log hain which need people to analyze their stuff so that make project, they can make projections, they can do budgeting on certain things. So analytics is a good field, and you can also go for specifically data analysis, artificial intelligence, and you know all that sector. That's in good demand here.
Right. So which relatives can sponsor us? Family visa Australia.
Oh, your direct relatives. I don't have an exact idea, but I have seen people jinke mama ne ya taya ji ne paise de rakhe hain. So I don't know if it can go beyond that, but exactly I really don't have any clue about it. But yeah, you can get sponsored as long as it's a close relative. But right, still, if you ask the counselor, they'll be, you know, able to give you a better outlook into that.
Awesome. So I guess questions to YouTube se khatam ho gaye, itne the questions. काफी ज्यादा questions आ गए थे last में. एक और जो आया था question from Instagram, वो ये था कि you know, do Indian students face any kind of racism in Australia? How is the Indian culture in Australia? The Indian community.
Indian community यहाँ पे काफी strong है, I would say. They support each other a lot. इन्होंने काफी सारे Facebook पे groups बना रखे हैं specifically for Indians, so they are helpful. जैसे हमारे initially आके कोई friend नहीं था. जब हम initially आए थे तो हमें एक security guard मिला. उनसे, वो भी Indian था, हरियाणा से था. फिर हमें और लोग मिले पंजाब से. तो अपनी community यहाँ पे काफी strong है. And as such racism नहीं होता, because I've seen Indian people in good posts as well. I've seen Indian people as a security guards as well. And I've seen Indian people gatekeeping as well. So, सारे हर जगह मैंने Indians देखे हैं. And मैंने पूछा भी है, like अपने friends जितने भी हैं Indians, हमसे बड़े हैं काफी, some are 27, some are 28. उन्होंने भी बताया, like there is no such racism. And मतलब अभी तक जहाँ पे मैं भी work कर रहा हूँ, I haven't faced any racism. I don't know. I don't think as of now any racism है. But अगर हाँ, मैंने कभी experience की, तो I'll definitely share it out. क्योंकि हमें पता है इनिशियली 2008-2010 में बहुत केसेस होते थे रेसिज्म के, एंड वी हैव स्टिल गॉट दैट कॉन्सेप्ट इन माइंड, बट इट्स प्रीटी कूल नाउ. आई डोंट थिंक ऐसा कुछ है, क्योंकि इंडियंस काफी है यहाँ पे. लाइक आई गेस अगर मैं इंटरनेशनल लोगों की बात करूँ, तो आफ्टर चाइनीज इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया सबसे ज्यादा आपको इंडियन, नेपालीज एंड पाकिस्तानी लोग ही मिलेंगे हु आर डूइंग मेजोरिटी ऑफ द ग्राउंड लेवल जॉब्स, एंड दे आर नॉट फीलिंग फेसिंग इन रेसिज्म. सो आई डोंट थिंक इट्स दैट मच.
So the last question for this life. Scope of engineering fields. So we have talked about, you know, IT plus commerce, right? Or IT plus business, right? What about core engineering fields like civil engineering or mechanical engineering? Uska kya scope hai?
उसका स्कोप है, बट देखो इतना नहीं है, झूठ नहीं बोलूंगा मैं, cause I've seen people जो इंजीनियरिंग करके आते हैं, बट यहाँ पे ना एज सच मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री इतनी ज्यादा नहीं है. और इंजीनियरिंग की फील्ड्स हैं, लाइक केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग और पेट्रोलियम इंजीनियरिंग, उन सब में काफी स्कोप है. बट जैसे इंडिया में जो सबसे फेमस इंजीनियरिंग फील्ड्स हैं, लाइक मैकेनिकल और इलेक्ट्रिकल, और लाइक सीएस हैज अ गुड फील्ड क्योंकि ऑब्वियसली वो आईटी में आ जाती है, बट सिविल इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिकल उनका स्कोप है, बट मैं बहुत ज्यादा नहीं बोलूंगा. लाइक इफ यू जस्ट लुकिंग फॉर अ डेस्क जॉब इन एनी कंपनी, आपको मिल जाएगी, बट यू आर लुकिंग टू गो इन अ कोर इंजीनियरिंग फील्ड, तो यहाँ पे इंडस्ट्रीज इतनी नहीं है जो मैन्युफैक्चर करती है फ्रॉम ग्राउंड. लाइक अगर आप डोमेस्टिक ऑस्ट्रेलियन में ऑटोमोबाइल की अगर बात करूँ, तो इनकी एज सच कोई कंपनी नहीं है विच इज लाइक वेरी फेमस अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, सारी कार्स बाहर से एक्सपोर्ट होती हैं, एवरी कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल भी यहाँ से बाहर से एक्सपोर्ट होता है, तो इम्पोर्ट होता है, सॉरी बाहर से इम्पोर्ट होता सारा. सो आई डोंट थिंक यहाँ पे इतनी इंडस्ट्रीज हैं, बट अगर आपको इन डेप्थ चाहिए तो आई वुड सजेस्ट यू अगेन आस्क अ काउंसलर अबाउट इट. बट हाँ, बट पेट्रोलियम माइनिंग एंड केमिकल इनका काफी स्कोप है. इफ यू आर फ्रॉम दीज थ्री बैकग्राउंड देन इट्स अ नो ब्रेनर फॉर यू. बट सिविल मैकेनिकल इलेक्ट्रिकल दे मे हैव स्कोप्स, बट उतना नहीं होगा टू एक्सटेंट ऑफ अदर फील्ड्स.
Right. Yeah. ठीक है. So, thank you a lot. Right. It was a great session. हमें बहुत सारे आए questions और हमने बहुत सारे questions मतलब सभी को लिया. Right.
Yeah. So, it was good for me too. Good experience and I, you know, it's good to have a session like this. और भी लोगों को they get help, lot of help and they get to know from a personal experience. Plus,
right.
You are doing a great job as you know connecting both ends. So. That's a great thing on your part. Yeah, so thank you for having me here.
Right. So guys, we are ending life. I hope it was useful. And okay then, see you guys. Yeah.